this magnitude and should really be suspended. Let us relook at it, even scrap, and let's go out to tendering as should have been done in the first instance. So lots of legal requirements were breached from the inception. That's why primarily we're calling for this contract to be suspended.
And so is your objection to the concept of paid parking as a whole?
No, but done correctly. With consultation, with accountability, and with transparency, we believe that it could work. But right now, this has breached all of that, and that's why we're asking for it to be suspended.
And so, based off of the recent meeting with central government, do you feel that there may be some progress towards that actual goal?
Yes, and we believe that if we continue to make our voices heard in the way we did this afternoon, that central government is going to acquiesce to the will of the people, which happens in a democratic society.
So thus far, it seems like there's more support from the central government than
yes.
the city. Okay.
Yes, and we're very thankful for that.
They're asking for lowering the cost. What's your take on that, on lowering the cost?
We want a suspension in the contract. This contract has breached a lot of legal requirements. Tendering is perhaps the most glaring. And on that note alone, the Ministry of Finance review of the contract says that it should be scrapped based on the fact that it did not follow the requirements for tendering.
This was the largest protest today. Where do you guys go from
was
here
it?
If there's no acquiescence to what you asked?
We will continue to look at what is happening, continue to gauge what the people are saying to us, and look to see what's happening in relation to the City Council and the government, and that will determine what our next move is.
So if I can ask, what are your thoughts about the parking meeting in front of the church?
Okay, no romantic.
Of course, that is one of the things that I spoke out against parking meetings in front of the churches, places like the Torrey Center, places like schools and so forth. And all of that goes into the narrative that this contract has not been thought of. And the years of experience this company is reporting to have had, they don't have it, because they would have known that you don't put parking meters in such sensitive areas. And again, that strengthens our point that this contract needs to be suspended. We need to look at the contract. That should be the starting point for choosing the contract.
There are some people who are saying that they don't have a problem, and in fact they are currently using, you heard the mayor say that at some locations the parking meter tickets are being sold out, going like hotcakes. What's your take on people who are saying that they don't have a problem?
There is talk and then there is reality. If you go around Georgetown and you look at the streets, I don't think you see a lot of cars using the parking meters. And so balancing that reality that you can observe for yourself with people saying parking meter tickets have been sold out.
So what about the people who are saying that your move is a backward move, that this is a progressive thing and that it will eventually catch on, just given time, and they are prepared to use it? What do you say to those people who don't have a problem with what's happening?
I'm not going to respond to that per se, besides saying that I believe we are on the right side of history. And you see the numbers out here this afternoon, the numbers have continued to grow, and the people calling for the contract to be suspended.